So hello and welcome to this calculatorial in which we are going to calculate a solid of revolution, the volume of a solid of revolution. So look at this, given the function that is this, quite simple, let's say for this level, calculate the volume of the solid of revolution when you rotate this graph on the x-axis. In the IVBA standard, you are always going to rotate through the x-axis, and you have a formula for that, which is the integral of the function, squared, okay? Not so much trouble for that. So the integral of the function squared. Now in this case, our function is minus x squared plus x. So what we are going to do is we are going to replace here by the pi. We are not going to replace, but the function we are going to replace by f of x and then squared. So we have x squared. We have looked that we have our function squared. Now let's talk about the limits. The limits will be the root of the function. So first you're going to take your calculator and you're going to draw the graph of the function that you have there, and you're going to see the graphs. You're going to see the graph and you're going to see the roots. So with the g-solve, let's find the roots. The roots is in 0 in the x and in 1 in the x. You must always use the numbers in the x of the roots to calculate the volume, or maybe the exercise says something different, but that depends on the exercise. Once that you decided which is the integral that you have to do, remember that you always must follow this formula, pi times the function squared. So pi times the function squared, and in this case the roots are the limits, so we put the 0 and 1 for the roots. Once you decided which is your integral, go to the menu for calculations and calculate that integral. Okay, to calculate the integral you go to options, then you go to calculus with f4, and then with f4 again you calculate the integral. Put whatever you see here, so you put pi times and then bracket, so minus x squared plus x, close the bracket, the square of that, and then put one little comma and start writing the limits of the integral. 0, another comma, 1, and now close the bracket. That bracket tells which is all the integral that you're doing, and these commas here tells the limits for the boundaries of the integral. Do that, and this number is the volume of the solid that you're looking for. Straightforward. Ta-da.